Hello to all of my BPTV fans, YouTube fans, Facebook fans, and new fans. I'm Alan Levine, the Talking Machine, doing my 27th Speedy Gourmet show. And I appreciate all of you watching, your comments, and even copycatting me. So carry on with this, and let's start the timer. First up, I'm trying something a little different. 90 seconds to cook rice, and it's a chicken roasted blend of it with herbs and stuff, and it cooks up really nice. I don't have to use my 23-year-old rice cooker. All right, with no further ado, we have some wild caught Pacific cod. And I ordered a dozen 6 ounces of fish, salmon, sockeye salmon, cod, halibut, and I'm down to the last couple, so I wanted to put this on the show. And it was frozen, and it's wild caught from the Pacific, and it's a nice 6 ounce piece. All right, let's cut this in. And the wild-caught fish, like I keep emphasizing, it's much healthier. And some people go, can you trust it? I go, well, I gotta trust somebody on our food. You know, they do so many different things to it and all the additives in there. And I'm just gonna trust the wild-caught. Little fight here today. 6 ounce piece, look how nice that is. Rinse it off. And I have a water filtration thing. When you turn it to the right, then it's unfiltered water. So I'm using unfiltered water to rinse it off. The other stuff's good to drink and it's filtered. All right, veggie time. I'll bring them out. I actually had some cauliflower left from last month, snap peas, and asparagus is so hard to buy. You need them thin like this. For the last year, they've been double the size. So, just so you know. All right. A couple more things for you, of course. White onion, red pepper, yellow pepper. You know I like colors. By the way, if you forgot, the more colors you have, the healthier it is for you. All right, Cutco knife coming out. Baby Bella mushrooms. And I leave them out. And they're still pretty good. Got them a few days ago, and I'll rinse them off. And let's see what we can do here. We'll cut the bag here. Watch your fingers, not for amateurs, and I'll put it in a container. Let me wash these off. And I grab a handful. Move the cod up to the cutting board. Rinse them off. We get mushrooms here, the Bella. You know how mushrooms are a little funky from the mushroom farms. And we'll get about 6 of these. Up, oh, there's one there. And we take the stems out and then we'll cut them. I'll get them in position there. All right, little adjustment there. Thanks to my cameraman, Nick. Put the mushrooms over there to cut. We're staging everything and we're specific with it. Last of the Mohicans, mushroom there. Little paper towel, got one handy. You know, I like to clean up after I get there, but we'll start doing that. And we got to pull out our tray. Yeah, our non-stick tray, we'll set it here. Olive oil from Odie's. And the rice is from Odie's also. A couple times I was using the brown rice and they're out of brown rice, so I had to get the white with the chicken roasted in there. All right, that's a little simple thing there. Rainbow peppercorns for later. All right, well, we're reaching here. Allen Pavanda, Allen's Gourmet Garlic Powder. 8 different varieties of garlic. Hold it, you know I gotta taste something. This is delicious. Delicious. And it keeps you healthy. Before antibiotics, garlic kept us alive. All right, then we're gonna bring my ceramic little pot. We're gonna put water in there, asparagus is gonna be in there, and we gotta pull another instrument out. You're seeing me do multiple things. My trusty wok. You see how it's sloped, just like a wok? Like a wok should be. Just talked to somebody the other day about that. Here's what we do here. Virgin olive oil, because I'm gonna cook some veggies in there. And see how it's solid? When it gets too warm, it turns liquid. So I put a tablespoon in there, and you can eat it. So many healthy benefits, skin, hair, health. Love the flavor. And since I'm not cooking for anybody else, I can sample a little stuff. If somebody else is here, I'm not going to overlap. And here's what I do. I put some water in there. And we're going to put veggies in there. We're going to go down there. Move this. Put our veggies there. We got to put our fish on here. And we might only have fish on here today. That's what we're looking at. All right, see the cauliflower is still good. No real brown spots. So we'll cut a little couple pieces off. You know I like to split things, watch your fingers. Try to move a little, get a good close up, split it. And we'll get a couple other to put in. And we're gonna do multiple cooking here. We're gonna put some in here. See these snow peas? They're going in there. We're gonna add water, again, the unfiltered water. And you'll like this trick. See these nice rubber bands? Purple, asparagus, and the thinner ones. And I'll grab 2, 4, 5, I like 6 today. And here's my secret to it. See the stalks? I cut about an inch off. And I get the more tender flavor from them. And we will wash them. And then stay tuned for my rubber band trick coming up. All right, here's the wash. All right, shake it off. All right, folks, for all you amateurs, get the rubber band. Put it here, and you notice how they stand up. They will stand up in the water. That's a couple Speedy Gourmet tips for you. So we make some room here, and it should stand. Whoop, we got a little slant there. Yeah, that cauliflower is in the way. All right, so we'll start doing that. I'm not gonna be able to put anything in there. I wasn't sure of my plan. You know I fly by the seat of my pants. We're gonna put this Pacific cod right in there. Always step away from the heat. I preheat it, and with this electric oven, it's at 465. And it works better for me. Cauliflower to the side. Asparagus back in a bag. So you can do this. Little ginger for later. Let me pull one out of this bag. And you know we're gonna shred this a little bit later. And we gotta cut the baby Bellas. 3 slices, maybe 4 on this, a little bigger. This one was a piece. Another one just two. And you see these are smaller, so we go like that. And you shouldn't walk across the kitchen, but I'm breaking a couple rules. We'll put it in here, and Nick, I'll show you when I get all the veggies in there. All right. And that'll be the prep there. This we'll put on a burner here, and we'll start that up. And don't forget about that rice. We got to get that out. Might as well get a plate. We're going to use, you got my China gunpowder, Lung Ching fourth grade. Oh, Young Hyson, wait, I got one that I just used the other day. Here's my surprise. Japanese sencha, loose leaf. Look at that, folks. All right. Thanks for the thumbs up, Nick. I can move forward. Got to open it up. You know the penguin T-ball. We're good there. And then I'll do it right in front of you since you guys are trying to learn this. Just put it there. Penny watching it. Happen to have a little teaspoon there. A little bit of cauliflower. And then I go in and I get, I'm near the end of this. This was a gift by my ex-sister-in-law, Judy. And here we put it in here. Pretty good job. Put the lid on. There's little notches. And look how handy it is. Closes up, nothing's coming out. We know I gotta eat a little. It's very tasty. All right. We'll get these peppers going. Red's one of my favorite peppers, nice and sweet. I like spicy peppers at times, but again, it's been tough to get some of them out there. For all my friends that have their gardens, I respect you. There we go. Now we cut it up thin. And watch your fingers. I'm not like on the professional shows. And just about little pieces, thin pieces to cook up real nice. Watch that finger there. All right. Get the sticker off. These darn stickers. And, oh, we missed one. Watch Joe's fingers, see right next to him. We're good. All right. Look at the yellow and red. How about that for a combo today? And you just go in there. There's a little core that's there. Look how I leave the core. And you just cut there and eye it so you miss the seed ball. Again, I cut the core out and I do it again. Try to be delicate. Watch those fingers. There, that's gone. Now we'll slice this up. And I'm going to bring the wok over because I can't carry all this without making a couple trips. One trip will help. And we'll get that going for us. Watch those fingers always. Just be safe. And you see the yellow is a little bigger than the red. So that'll dominate a little. And the little stem part. These were all pre-washed, so I wanted to tell you that. And I wash all that and put some of it in. All right, before I get the onion, we're going to do some wok. Some Aerosmith wok this way. All right, look, it's filling up. Look, Nick, you can get that. And then we have it here, so I'm going to set it right there. And Nick, I'm going to do something I like to do. And for all you fans, cut up some ginger to give us some flavor. And then I'll use shredded ginger. So we're going to double up a little because it's so healthy and digested and stuff. and you can just cut it up in little pieces. And here's how simple it is. One handful all over that. Ginger, stay tuned. All right, we cut our onion, one stem off, bottom stem off, and I put a little Nick in it, no pun intended with Nick, my cameraman, and I pull that off, and I lose some of the onion, but it's much better, and look at the shape it's in there. All right, steady with your hand. I cut it little circles there, look how nice they are. Then I split them in half and break them up. So there's 3, 4, 5, and guess what? 7's our lucky number on this. 1, cut it again. Very simple, about halfway in there. If you're a little off, it's all gonna cook up. All right, we got a, that wok's right here. Glad I left it, saved a couple steps. Bang, bang. And then I break them up in here. Oh, I missed that one. See, we all can make mistakes. There we go. And if he follows me, we're just breaking them up a little. See how they just form their little half moons like? Little smile for you guys. And the onions, you know, I got a taste. I eat what I cook, sometimes before I cook it. And it's very tasty and good. Follow me down here. We put it on high here. And see the glass lid? I put it in there to get it started up a little. I gotta rinse up a little bit here. I gotta use my towel, I'm a little wet here. Nobody reminded me we need the thermometer my daughter Casey got me. Best gift I got a couple years ago. And I take it right out. Put it back. Get it ready. Little thermometer comes out. You hit it and it starts it. And we need 145. 145 on that, folks. All right, we gotta clip this bag. And you only cook it for 90 seconds. If you've watched it before, you see how efficient it is. I squeeze it a little. Here's what it looks like. It's all pre-cooked. 90 seconds. All right, we got it boiling with the asparagus, and it doesn't want to stay up. I'm not going to fight it. We need a fork. We got the spoon there. Give it a quick rinse. All right. We better start the tea. My daughter got me this Cuisinart. Thank Casey for that. For my birthday, how do I look in purple? She got me another new polo. 175 for green, and you hit start. And we'll be ready. As we move these things to the refrigerator, I might get blocked out a little bit, but all right. We will set the teacup up and let's check that timer there. About 18 minutes here. 19 minutes we're hitting. So we're shooting for under 25. Here, we'll put the tee ball in. We got to get the shredder out. Handy shredders I have for 20 plus years. Look, it slides right out of the notch here. Look how simple. Even for a guy like me, very simple. And we will be doing that. We may need to check the fish. So we'll do a little prelim. All this action silicone glove, handiest thing you can get. always step back a little. All right, it's looking good there. Wow, we have a winner with the fish. I'm just gonna set it on the plate. Watch your fingers. There we go. Tastes wonderful. Even though it's warm out, I do vent my oven in here, and we're getting a little smoke in here. I'm gonna have to crack the window. And we're moving right along. Guess what? It's rice time. 90 seconds here. All right. We're getting down there with this. Our veggies are looking good. Wow, it is smoky. This is like a live cooking show on TV, so. Fresh asparagus, we don't need that. All right, you can hear that rumbling a little bit. You don't want to boil your water for tea. 175 is less than boiling, and you use that. That's the secret. All right, we'll stage a couple more things. Whoa, put the Japanese sencha away. All right, one more thing here for you, Nick. Organic olive oil, extra virgin. We will use that. All right, and our veggies are coming up here. Yeah, they're cooked, a little hot. And we have some action here. Get our plastic spatula out there to mix it up. I may not use all those vegetables on my plate, that we will give it our best try. Here we go. We're moving right along. We got rice. This is very hot. Let me move the fish a little. You know I like to load up my plate. Wow, that is hot. And we spread that rice out all along the plate. You know how I line things up, try to make it look presentable in that Mediterranean diet type thing. Rice, and we'll put our cod right there so I can line veggies up on it and around it. All right, be careful with this. Oh, they feel very tender. Rubber band. All right, snap peas. Got to get them individually. We got our rice and other veggies cooking away in the water with virgin coconut oil. Why do you see that? Here we go. A couple more. Snap peas. All right, we better toss some cauliflower up there. You heard the beep. Guess what? We're ready for green tea. All right, I'm ready with the veggies here. And the water's cooking down. Let me do a little swish here. Get that all in there. All right. Can't beat this. Here we go. Steady hand again. All right, 2 minutes or less. Let's see where we're at on this. Whoa, we're at 24 minutes. This has been extended with everything I got going on, so we're gonna be closing this down shortly. All right, we got some veggies here. Put them right on here. And you see, I didn't use about half of the veggies, so. One more there. We're shut down there. We're ready, folks. All right, tea's looking good. We'll set that down. Ginger on everything. Ginger's flying. All over the meal. There, you get that ginger that hangs up, all off, set down. All right, garlic. There for the camera. Rainbow peppercorn coming at you. Just twist it up from Trader Joe's. Love the rainbow peppercorn. All right, last thing up. The olive oil, extra virgin. Got a mushroom up there. We'll put that with my fish. Very tasty, very good. That is it, folks. Let's hit the timer. You know, I'm disappointed. I always want to shoot 25 minutes or less. Had a couple records the last few months. Look at the meal that I made in that length of time. I'm so proud and honored to be doing these shows for you. We got the penguin here. Sugar snap peas. We got red pepper, yellow pepper, white onion, Bella mushrooms, asparagus, thin asparagus. That's what you want. It's more tender. And then we got that chicken roasted herbs and carrots, white rice. And it tastes very good. 90 seconds to do it. Loose leaf green tea, Japanese sencha from Japan. And this is all I have for you. Please try to emulate this and have fun with your wild caught fish. Till the next show, the third Wednesday of August. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.